So I have a couple of questions here regarding the piano roll. So the first one is how to show the notes in the piano roll from other channels. This is a good question, and I think it's one of the things that is very helpful. So let me switch to FL Studio. So one of the things that I found here in FL Studio when I'm making music is I really like to make all my compositions in one pattern and then split that pattern into several patterns. So what I like to do basically, it's, let's say that I go here and I go to piano roll and I put here a chord, C minor, for example, and then I put another one, something like this. So let's say that I have these two chords. And what I like to do is, if I load another sound here, I like to have the ability to check these notes here. And you can see that all the notes that are from the sampler are shown here in the background. And this is very helpful, at least for me, because I'm not the best when it comes to music theory. So I have certain tools that I use here in FL Studio to help me out become a better producer. So it's kind of a crutch. I really suggest that you study music theory. It's very helpful when we want to make music, but at the same time, FL Studio provide us here with a bunch of good tools so that it can help us to make better music. So these are called ghost notes. And now that I know that I have all these chords here, I can just go ahead and put notes in between, or not in between, but I can match the notes that I was using in the other instruments, and then I can have them here with a little bit of simplicity, I guess. I can follow pretty much the same structure that I was using in the other ones. If I didn't have the ghost notes, it would be a little bit harder for me to know which notes I played in the other instruments. Sometimes it can be a little bit confusing. Also, if you have a bunch of sounds, especially drums, it can make this a little bit confusing. But it's also a good thing. And one good option of this one is you just go here, right click two times, and it switches to the other plugin. So this is also a very cool option that you can have here. So let's go ahead and, by the way, let me show you how to enable this, which is, let's go here, view, and then you have note grid highlights. And no, actually it's not this one. Let me see, is I have to select this one and go view, and where is it? Ghost notes. If I take this off, you see that the notes disappear. And now it's a little bit harder for me to follow the other notes, because yeah, I can't see. So it's at least for me, it's kind of a harder way to make music. So I really enjoy this option of seeing the ghost notes. It makes my life really, really easy when it comes to making music and music theory. So that's a really good tool that I think FL Studio has here. And yeah, so